Hello everyone, welcome to EDU for sure. Today we're going to see about data visualization using Matplotlib library. So in this lecture, I will going to explain you the different kind of graphs and charts and plot that you can graph that you can draw it with the help of Matplotlib library and Python programming. So let's see that what actually the data visualization. And in this lecture, I will going to explain you everything about this Matplotlib library. So let's start. So as you can see my screen, this is matplotlib.org official website where you can get complete detail about Matplotlib library. What are the installation step, documentation, example, tutorial, everything is here. You can explore from your site. As you can see here, different kind of a graph you can form with the help of Matplotlib library. Here, these are the table of content where you can see line graph, bar, images, subplot, statistic, pie chart, and various graph you can see it. So first, once you click on the installation, you can get the detail of how to install it, right? You can see installation steps. All the installation steps are mentioned here. And you can read it and you can understand it, like what actually this installation step, how to install Matplotlib library. It is one of the open source library, just like NumPy, Pandas that we have seen in our previous lectures. So this is library also an open source. It's a complete open source library. This is the installation step. Once you click on download options or documentation, so once you click on this documentation options or so once you click on this, let me click here, you can get the complete detail here, like installation, what are the documentation here. In this documentation, they will going to tell you about the latest release of this Matplotlib library, which is August 13, 2021. Then once you click on this installations, you will get the installation documentation. Similarly, once you click again, you click on tutorial, so you will get the tutorials and many more information about this Matplotlib library. So what you have to usually do, you just have to click here and type matplotlib.org, which is your official website. Once you click on this matplotlib.org, it will going to open. You can see here the same thing that I'm showing you here. It is the same. Similarly, you can open it for other library also that I explained you previously, pandas.org. So Pandas is also having an official document that you can refer to follow Pandas detail. So as I said you, for Pandas also, when you type pandas.pydata.org, you will get the complete detail about the Pandas library, about Pandas, how to start working with Pandas library, documentation, whatever I cover in my Pandas lecture and in the project, you can go through this official website to learn about or to get the more detail about Pandas library. Similarly, this is your NumPy library. So with a Matplotlib library, I thought to share you about this Pandas and NumPy library as well. Here also you can get the installation step, documentation, and everything you can get it about NumPy library. So in this lecture, but I will going to explain you data visualization, and we'll going to draw different graphs. Like you can see here, bar graph, horizontal bar, this different graph, we will going to plot it, and I will going to show you the meaning of data visualization and how to draw the different graphs with Matplotlib library. So let's start. Before going ahead, this tutorial also you can follow in case if you want to go more depth and want to know more about this data visualization, because different kind of graphs are available, how to change the color, how to use different graphs. You can learn it from this tutorial as well. So let's see about in our practical session. I will going to show you in Jupyter Anaconda notebook platform how you can draw different kind of graphs with the help of Matplotlib open source library that is completely free, and you don't have to pay any license amount for that, and you can use it freely. So let's start working our hands-on lab session on this Matplotlib library. So this is my Jupyter Anaconda notebook platform where I will going to run the code. So how you do that? Just you need to click on Jupyter Anaconda. Once you click on Jupyter Anaconda or Anaconda Navigator, you will get this screen. Once you click on this Jupyter notebook option, which is this one, remember this symbol. Once you click on this Jupyter notebook, click on the launch option. It will going to open in your by default browser. So as you can see here, this Jupyter notebook is open now. Now I will going to click on this new option, Python 3. So it will going to open a new tab where I will going to start writing the code. So let's see how to install Matplotlib library. So here I rename the file. As you can see, data visualization with Matplotlib. Now we're going to start installation part. So this is the installation statement, or you can say installation instruction, pip install matplotlib. So as you can see here, this requirement is already satisfied, because I have run this data visualization with Matplotlib before also. But when you will going to do in your system first time, it will going to show you successfully install. So this is the step of installing Matplotlib library. You can see this library is installed in my D drive, Jupyter Anaconda lib folder. And what is the version of that? 3.3.4. So we have successfully installed and configure the matplotlib library with our Jupyter notebook environment. So let's start running the code here. Once you install it successfully, you have to import this library. So let's see how to import matplotlib library and how to add this matplotlib library with your code. So you can see here, I imported matplotlib library. So the instruction that we usually write in a Python, import matplotlib library dot pyplot, which is a submodule inside this matplotlib library, and plt is an alias name. You can take any other alias name also. As this is a short form, so I have taken this. You can take any other. Similarly, this numpy is for reading the data from your data frame in the vector or array, and pandas is to read a data frame. We're going to read a data set here. I am going to show you that data set. So that's why I've imported numpy and pandas library as well. Now let's run this. So this file is imported successfully. So let's start doing data visualization. So let me write down the whole code, then I will explain you line by line what this line represent, and I will going to add a comment also with that all the line. So when you will going to run this file on your system, you will be able to understand what this line means. So as you can see here, I have drawn the graph, and now when I'm running this, it is showing me the graph like this. And this asterisk symbol is coming as a relation between x and y axis. This graph is very large. Let me reduce some size of this graph. So to reduce the size, just take it 5, 5. That will be 5 is your length and 5 is your breadth. So let me rerun again. So you can see now the graph is coming small, and this asterisk symbol is showing the relation between your x and y axis. You can see this is your y axis and this is your x axis. And what is the label of the graph? First graph data visualization is my label of the graph. And here the asterisk symbol that I have passed here is now coming as a line. In place of asterisk symbol, if I give it hyphen and I rerun it with 3, 3, because 5, 5 also it looking very large. So let me take 3, 3 and rerun once again. So now you see this. Okay, I need to make changes here also. So now you see this, the line is coming with a line graph. Means for 0, there is a value. So this is between x and y axis. X is your this value that will come, that are coming here. And y is this value that is coming here. Because of the figure size, they are changing this value so as to accommodate clearly all the values. Just don't think like I am passing x 0, 1, 2, 3 and y it is coming 2, 4, 6, 8. This is your x axis. This is your y axis. To just accommodate all the values and the relation between x and y axis, it is showing the graph like this. And the title of this graph is first graph data visualization. X label will be this, y label will be this. You can change this title, x label and y label, with any other sentence or any other string value or any label, just to show you how the data visualization happened with Matplotlib library. This PLT is my Matplotlib library's submodule, and this is an alias name. PLT is an alias name, and I'm calling here this alias name, and I'm drawing this graph. So I hope it is clear to you how to do the data visualization. I will going to show you some more graph. Let's see that. Okay. So let's see now with another graph, how to draw the scatter plot. This is the line graph that I've shown you. Let's see about the scatter plot, how to draw the scatter plot with the x and y axis. So you can see here, we draw the scatter plot successfully. How we draw the scatter plot? I call this scatter function in this pyplot submodule. So I call this plt.scatter. So it will going to draw the scatter plot or set scatter graph between your x-axis and y-axis. If you have seen previous example that I've shown you on this data visualization, I've just call this plt.plot on my x-axis and y-axis, and what kind of graph I want, I have given the label there. You can see the hyphen symbol and this label. So this is another kind of a variation how you can draw the graph. So here I draw the scatter plot with this x and y axis. You can see, and the label I have given anything from my side. I have taken this random. Geek actually means who is passionate to learn new technology. So I just given the title Geek for Python Data Science Learning. Who is passionate to learn data science and Python? Geek actually means who is passionate to learn new technology. So I've just given this title. If you want, you can change the title. You can change the X label and Y label. I'm drawing between time and learning rate. With respect to time, what is my learning rate or my learning performance? So based on that, I'm drawing this scatter plot. So for this two value, what is your, for this X2, what is your Y value? 5. So you have draw this plot here. For this X value 5, for X value 5, what is your Y value? 10. So it is coming here. For X value 9, what is your Y value? For X value 9, Y value is 8. So it is coming here. This is your Y value, which is vertical, and X value is your horizontal. Similarly, for X value 4, your Y value is also 4, so it is coming like this. For X value 7, Y value is 2, so it is coming like this. So I hope you are clear about for forming a different kind of a graph and plot with the help of Matplotlib library. Let's see some more graph. Now we're going to show you how you can read a data set and you can draw the graph with the help of Matplotlib library. Now here you can see that I have some file, and this is my file that I save it here. So now here I will going to show you how you can make a graph on any data set. So let me show you the data set. It is a gas price data set, the price of LPG gas for various countries. So it's showing you that. Let me open this file. So I'm opening this file in a notepad. So you can see this is my file. In this file, I have a column here, Australia, Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Italy, Japan, Mexico, South Korea, UK, and US. And this all data, different country wise, I have a data for this gas price. It means that on particular year 1990, what will be the gas price in Australia, Canada, France, and all. And why it is coming like this? Because we have opened it in a notepad. You should be aware about this also, that this is a CSV file, comma separated file. What do you mean by that? Every value will be separated by comma. You can see here 1990 comma, then 1, then comma. So every value here is separated by a comma. So this is called comma separated value file. I will going to show you how you can draw the graph based on the variation in the price of gas in a various country. So let's see that. So we come to the same Jupyter Anaconda notebook environment. In this platform, I will going to show you how to read a data set, gas price data set, and perform data visualization on any data set. So let's see that how to do data visualization on any data set or set of a data. So here I'm reading a file in my system path. So this is the path where I have a file, guess price CSV. You can see here, this is the D drive. In that D drive folder, in this D drive matplotlib folder, I have this guess price file. I am reading this file. So you can see here, we have read the data, which is in the form of CSV. And now I will going to print the data. So I will going to call, just type the variable name where I've read this whole CSV file and I'll going to run it. Now you can see we have the whole file with us, guess price. So in this year 1990, this price, NaN is what? Not a number. It means that for the year 1990, we don't have a data for the Australia gas price data. Means we don't have a data what was the price of a LPG gas in Australia. Similarly for other value, if you see in Canada it was 1.87, France 3.63, Germany 2.65. like this, these are the different value. It might be in any any dollar, any values, any unit, or any currency, I should say. It can be in any currency, that doesn't matter. But here are the values. It might be in a dollar or some other currency based on that country. So these are the data. So I've shown you how you can read a data from your system. Similarly, when you will going to do this step, you just have to pass the path where this file will be present. As I have passed my D drive directory, like you can see here, this D drive, I have a file, guess price CSV file. So I pass it here. You have to pass like that only. Now let's start doing data visualization on this guess price CSV data set. So let's start. I will going to explain you every instruction. Let me write down the whole code. Then I will going to explain you line by line. What does it meaning of each and every instructions in this data visualization lectures. So I am assuming here every value here is in US dollar. So I'm taking United States dollar here. So I'm just typing USD. Every value I'm assuming in USD of this data set for different country. So here you can see I'm getting some error. So I'm resolving the same. When you will going to do, you will also get some error. You just have to understand where you are doing mistake. And based on that, you need to debug the code. So I'm just looking the same here. So you can see here, I made changes here in the code. There was some error. An error was generating because this BR is for coloring and I was giving a wrong value of this color. B for blue, R for red, G for green, Y for yellow, and G again for green. I was giving F, which is that marker F doesn't represent any color, right? So that's the reason I was getting error. And I resolved it now. As you can see here in this graph, I'm drawing the graph of size 8x5. 8 is my length and 5 is my breadth. So this is the final graph which representing the relation between year and US dollar. And this green line representing those graph, yellow, red, blue. So that was representing the color. I was giving the France F, and their F is doesn't represent anything in the coloring. And that's the reason we are getting error. So I remove that. But if you want, you can add a France and give any color like from the marker that I've already explained you in my Matplotlib lectures. In the slide, I've explained you what are the marker that you can use it, what are the coloring you can use it to make a graph more attractive. So in this graph, I'm giving the title. And fun dict is one component that you have to add it to decide what will be the font size, font style, what will be the size. So font size is here 18 and font weight will be bold, means font style is bold. So that's the reason gas price over time in a USD is coming in a bold. After that, in this gas variable where I'm reading my data set, if you have seen here, this is my variable where I read my whole data set. In this path, I read the file. So this variable is having column year, Australia, Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, Mexico, and other column. So I'm just taking one by one those column. Like here, I'm taking my X axis as a year and Y axis as a US, and the color will be blue and the label will be United States. In the next line, I'm drawing the graph with x-axis will be year, y-axis will be Canada with red color. Similarly, x-axis will be year, y will be your South Korea with a green color. Similarly, if you see Australia will be representing with yellow. So x-axis will be your year, all the year from the starting to end year. And this is your US dollar, which is your x-axis. And this is your representing your x-axis will be your year. This is your representing your country wise, the different graphs. So this way you will going to draw the relation between year and country wise gas price. So this side will be the price of that particular country will come as the green, yellow is for Australia, red and blue is for some other country. So red is for Canada, blue is for US. And South Korea and Germany will have a green. So like this, you need to draw X label, whatever you will going to take, it will going to show you. So I've taken year and Y label as a US dollar. That's why it is representing here. Year as my X axis, US dollar as my Y axis. And I'm saving this image in this notebook itself. So I save this image in my notebook as gas price figure PNG. So it will going to save it with this DPI 300. DPI means a quality of an image dot pixel per inch. Dot pixel per inch. So here I have added a comment also. This represent color. X axis is your year. Y axis is a gas price in a different countries. Such as Canada here. And here this statement or instruction representing taking x axis for all years starting from 1990 to 2011. This is the size of a figure. And this will going to save an image. PLT.legend will going to print your PLT.legend will going to show a graph. So I hope it is clear to you how to draw the graph, how to perform data visualization, how you can read any data set, and you can draw the graph between x-axis and y-axis by selecting any column from the data set as your x-axis. And similarly for y-axis, you can give a label according to your requirement, as I have given here, year and US dollar. So you can draw a similar graph like that for various data set, for various column. So I hope it is clear to you. In this way, you can draw bar graph, horizontal bar graph, histogram, pie chart, and various graph you can draw. And you can follow matplotlib.org official website to learn more about this data visualization. So I hope it is clear to you about what is data visualization and how to draw the graph, how to read X label data set, Y label, how to read a column from the data set and perform data visualization with different coloring, different font style and different label. So I hope you find this session interactive and useful. We'll keep sharing such interesting session with you. Keep learning, keep practicing and keep practicing on this Python programming with this various libraries, which is open source library like NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, and this data visualization will going to help you to understand the pattern of the data, to understand what actually the data is. Like this graph, you can understand that the price of a gas is going up and down. There is a rise and fall in the price of the gas as you are moving with the year. So it will going to give you relation between year and the price of the gas. So this way, the data visualization is helpful in understanding the pattern of the data. So keep learning, keep practicing this Matplotlib library and data visualization with this Python programming. Till then, take care. Bye.